Okay, when if I'm wrong? When if I'm wrong about the economy? When if the economy recovers? You know, I always have to think about the possibility that my assumptions are incorrect because, you know, I've been wrong in the past. I was wrong about the last election. I was wrong about weapons of mass destruction being in Iraq. But I feel more confident in my forecast for the future regarding the economy because this opinion is based on facts as opposed to times where I base my opinions based on what the government told me, such as there's weapons of mass destruction in Iraq. But, you know, if I'm wrong, you know, I still feel comfortable about this channel. You know, I still think that I'm absolutely right about what's going to happen with the economy. I would love to be wrong about this one thing right here, you know. This is the one thing I want to be wrong about because it means that the job market will get a lot better and the economy will recover and things will get a lot better for me and for others. But, you know, I don't regret the things I've done on this channel because I feel like the information that I've given people has been pretty accurate. I feel like the advice that I've been giving people has been pretty good because when I tell people to get food, when I tell people to store up on ammunition, to store up on guns and things like that, I'm talking about protecting yourself. I'm talking about preparing for an emergency. And if things don't get worse and things do get better, at least people have those things to protect themselves and they can still use these things, you know. People won't get hurt by following my advice. Anyway, comments. Ray Cheetah wrote, "Wow, Reg, you sure have dispelled some preconceived notions for me. I figured Flint would be just another hellhole like Detroit, but it's actually a pretty nice town." Well, yeah, I wanted to focus on some positive things about Flint because you always hear the negative things, and I thought it would be kind of boring to only focus on the negative things. I thought it would be more interesting to show that, you know, yes, the city has a problem with crime. Yes, the city has a problem with unemployment, obviously, but there are some positive things going on in the city, and the city still has something to offer. Now, it's interesting because some people say that I'm too negative, but then other people say that I'm overly optimistic. Solar Windstar wrote, "Hey, Demcad, I search high and low for a wife who sees eye to eye with me on religious and political views, and has worked out awesomely. Especially since we had our first child 3 months ago, and we agree with each other on how we're going to raise her. Peace." Well, you know, I'm happy for you. You know, I'm always happy to hear success stories. You know, Bad John wrote, "Yeah, channels like these are the Misery Loves Company Club. Okay, it's rough times indeed, but it's still possible to manage if you think. What I witness here is paralysis caused by fear. Many of these people choose professions that are outdated or they have nothing to offer and they're scared, so they blame the president or the government. As Americans, we have so many options. I have friends in New York and blah, blah, blah." Okay, interesting things he said right there. "As Americans, we have many options." He's ignoring the fact that some Americans have a lot more options than other Americans. And I also thought it was interesting that he's blaming the workers. You know, he's blaming them on not having the right professions, not having anything to offer. He's blaming the workers. And like Gerald Celente says, they love to blame the little guy. You know, it's interesting how he doesn't mention anything about Goldman Sachs. He doesn't mention anything about the Federal Reserve. He doesn't mention anything about the government's responsibility in this downturn. But instead, he goes after the people. Very interesting stuff. Okay, Martian 74 wrote, "I didn't hear any gunshots during the video. Are you sure that this is Flint, Michigan?" Yeah, I did a video on Flint, Michigan. And no, he didn't hear any gunshots. And you know, it's pretty early in the morning, you know. You know, it's pretty early in the morning, and I was in a pretty good area of Flint. And again, I wanted to show some positive things that were going on in Flint. Shoot the Messenger 33 wrote, "I think this belief in apocalypse then utopia needs to be trashed." When did I ever talk about an apocalypse or a utopia? I mean, when? Never. He goes on to say, "It stems from our neo-Christian idea of death and rebirth. What does this have to do with me? He continues and says, maybe the phoenix doesn't have to rise from the ashes. Maybe if we let go of this belief, an inner desire to see the sinners punished and really work at the falling goal, we may simply bring about a better world without a need for destruction. Did I ever say there was a need for destruction? I mean, what is this guy talking about? I like how people like inject religion into things that have nothing to do with religion. Like, huh? I'm not talking about the end of the world. This economic downturn is not the end of the world, okay? I'm just simply saying that things are going to get really, really rough, and this society is breaking down, but there's going to be an opportunity to build something better. And if we're smart about it, we'll learn from our mistakes. That's all I'm saying. Sky Ding wrote, I think it's time to admit that Barack Obama saved the economy. Oh. Not one job created, but you saved the economy. He goes on to say, we are no longer losing jobs anymore. Oh, even California is creating jobs. $8, $9 an hour. How can I help you, jobs? In California. Okay, great. We're still losing jobs, okay? And by the way, government's 11,000 job number doesn't make any sense, okay? Because usually it's somewhat close to ADP, and ADP was 169,000. But all of a sudden, there's like a difference of 150,000 or so. I mean, don't you think that's a little bit suspicious? I said it once, I'll say it again. There's no such thing as a jobless recovery. Oh yeah, I also want to mention that I have a blog, and you guys might want to check it out in case this channel gets shut down for some reason. And on my blog, I'm going to be talking about the economy and a lot of other things. So I hope you guys give my blog a chance. Well, thank you for watching my video. Please rate my video. It really helps my videos. I appreciate your support. I'm sure you guys are going to have plenty more comments, so feel free. Bye, guys.